through a short reason of explanation, we require either an Arkansas driver's license or we require a voter registration form, a copy of those attached to that documentation. This is a document that also has to be notarized, and we do have a notary in our office, in the Office of Admissions. That is strictly for domestic students, for United States citizens, but those students that are out of state that have lived in 6 months, lived 6 months in Arkansas and can demonstrate that to us, there is that application form. Does that answer your question?
International.
For international students.
International students, Tom, do you want to take that? Because we just talked about it. We just talked about it.
Well, I'm not sure I'll answer. I'll do the best I can. This, for lack of a better word, is a quagmire. Sometimes there's a federal law that if someone is a non-resident alien, that we can't give that person a better benefit than we do a non-resident U.S. citizen. So you have a federal law that's hanging out there that's been interpreted a variety of different ways. So clearly, under UCA policies, if you live on campus, like you just stated, you're covered. Then that way everyone is treated the same, whether you're an Arkansas resident, a resident of the state of Oklahoma, or from a foreign country, international student. So they're all treated the same on campus. When you get off campus, you have this federal law that you have to take into account. And until all those things are resolved and some other things at the state level, it's hard to know what to do. Because quite frankly, based on our review of what other Arkansas institutions do, we're all over the lot, okay? But on the question of the federal law, we've been instructed that we're all going to follow it, and we are. Dr. Mayers has been clear on that since he got here, that what that provision in federal law says is we're going to comply with. So I think what Ms. Hatfield said is correct, but then every time a question like this comes up, we have to make sure we're not running afoul of federal law. Okay, I hope that answers your question. I know every time a lawyer stands up, everybody either says, A, I hate him, or B, I'm not going to listen. And I don't blame you. But I think that's a correct statement. If I said anything wrong, Jack.
There's one other thing that I'll mention to you. The state of Arkansas recently, a couple of years ago, imposed a limit on the percent of the university's budget that we can allocate to scholarships. And right now, the university is in the process of shrinking its scholarship budget rather than expanding it. So the prospect of being able to do that right now doesn't seem very good given the budget constraints that we have. And that was imposed on us by the Arkansas General Assembly. And we're working through that now. We have to reduce our
the law requires us to be at 20% of tuition fees by fall 2013. But to meet the fall 2013, I guess I should stand, right? But I don't need a microphone because I'm an old professor and you can hear me. But to be at 20% by fall 2013, we have to have that ready to go by fall 2012. And we're now about to reach fall 2010. We have 2 more years to reduce our scholarship spending as a percentage of E&G revenue, tuition and fees revenue. We've got 2 years now to reduce it by another 5 or 6%. And the way the law's written, those kinds of tuition waivers would count against our scholarship spending. And so it really puts a significant pressure on other things that we're trying to do with scholarship dollars. But it's part of the mix. It,